Happy tax day. I did take care of my taxes. I don't have a wife to take care of my taxes.
That's sexist. Marie Jean-Pierre saying that she doesn't have a wife to take care of her taxes. Like, that's, you know, what wives do is they just take care of the, you know, the taxes. That's all they, I mean, we hire somebody, lady. I don't know if we hire a firm to take care of our taxes. Thank you. I'm sorry. The government theft. That's what it is. It's yesterday was National Government Theft Day, a.k.a. the Day of Rage. And so what better way to celebrate our National Day of Rage than bringing on our friend Grover Norquist, who's the president of Americans for Rage Reform, Tax Reform. And he joins us from the pit in D.C. Grover, always good to see you. I am not pleased at all, especially when I was reading what you had to say about what would happen if Democrats get their way. They get everything that they want. They get those unrealized gains tax. They get all of this stuff. And what that means for our economy and what to expect after if they get their way. I was depressed, frankly. Tell us about it. Make us all sad.
This year hurt. But as you point out, yeah, a year from now, look, in the movies and in the cartoon books, the evil, sinister, evil person writes out his plans to take over the world, and then you see them and you can stop them. And Biden has written down his plans for you and your family and any investments you have or property you own or business you might be involved in. And he's made it very clear what he's going to do to you if he gets a House and a Senate and the presidency next year by one vote margin. That's all he needs, okay? He's going to raise taxes on small businesses. He's going to raise taxes on individuals. He's going to raise taxes on energy, another $47 billion on top of everything else. On the capital gains tax, he's going to take it to 44.6%. That is on page 80, footnote 19. And what he says is 44.6% plus your state tax. So if you're in California, 60%. You and your spouse, you build a small 60%. Business. You spend decades, two, three, four decades building it. You sell it. That's your retirement. That's the amount of money you're going to live on. No. Federal government's going to take almost half of it. New York and New Jersey and California, they'll take more than half of it. That's his capital gains tax. Oh, by the way, China steals 20%. Biden, 44.6. You want to compete in a world where investors say, let's say, should I build a steel mill in China? They steal 20%. Or in Biden's America, they steal 44.6%. And in California, 60%. How about that? Where does investment go? Where do jobs go if Biden does that? The corporate income tax, same thing. China's at 25. We would go higher than that under Biden, higher than China, higher than European average, higher than France, higher than Britain. Again, where do you invest? Where do jobs get created when Biden is taxing every business in America higher than China does? This is not just bad for the economy. It is bad for your job, your raises, your ability to move forward. And then he's got a couple of things he sort of hints at. I mean, he talks about them all the time, but he didn't put them down in the evil scientist plan for next year. And that is a carbon tax, meaning a tax on breathing and other things, carbon dioxide. But an energy tax, real energy tax, tax on all energy that actually produces energy, as Europe does. He also makes it clear, and he said this before, that he wants to put a floor under American taxation so that we can never be taxed less than the people in Europe. And by the way, Brussels and Paris will have a veto on whether we could take our business taxes down so that we could compete. Biden wants us to compete on low wages against China, not low taxes. He wants higher taxes than China, not less regulation. He wants higher regulations than China. We will compete on lower wages with China and lower wages than with Europe. That is not what a successful country or an independent. Britain used to tell us what kind of taxes to have. We started shooting at them and they left, okay? He's inviting Europe back in to tell us what our tax rate should be.
That's a great point. We're talking with Grover Norquist. This is, I mean, the fact that China would actually outpace us, that they beat us in terms of these lower corporate is craziness. And this, I mean, you're just driving jobs overseas at a time when we're trying to be as self-sustaining as possible due to instability elsewhere around the world. I mean, I don't see how this would play with the Rust Belt, particularly. I don't see this playing well with them at all.
Well, the Rust Belt is the Rust Belt because we used to live under corporate taxes under Obama and so on at 35%, much higher than China, much higher than Europe. Under Trump, we took 35 down to 21, which, by the way, only makes us competitive. It doesn't. Trump wanted to go to 15. That would have made us very competitive. 21, you know, it's sort of where Europe is. It's kind of the average around. It's okay, but we should be more competitive on lower taxes so we can have higher wages when we compete.
And we need that. This is not going to go towards paying down any debt. Because government's not, without any reduction in government spending, we always are told, well, we're going to, if we have any kind of tax cut, we're going to risk the budget. Well, the budget, we have more a record government revenue coming in. And now that doesn't make any sense, Grover. It doesn't make any sense. This is not going to go towards paying down any debt. This is just, we're with the government spending, we're in this horrible cycle.
Democrats raise taxes in order to spend the money. They don't raise taxes to pay down
debt.
Ever. They raise taxes so they can spend it. And then they not only spend it, but then they go, you know, we talked them into a tax increase last year. So let's spend more on the basis that we know we could talk them into a tax increase. So we'll get another tax increase next year. So every time there's been one of these bargains, when they cheated Reagan, when they cheated Bush, when they tried to cheat us under Obama, but we stopped them. Each time they wanted not real spending cuts, just tax increases and no spending cuts at the end of the day.
And they always act as though it's your patriotic duty to pay taxes. I was reading some of the arguments that Mark Cuban, which I'm sure that you've seen, talking with our friend Grover Norquist, Americans for Tax Reform. He was trying to, I guess, impress everyone with how much in tax he paid. You know, like I think it was, I don't even remember what the total was. A ridiculous amount of money.
$270 million.
Yeah, a ridiculous amount of money. I thought I paid a lot in tax this year. I mean, I had a stroke writing the check to, you know, the Treasury. I just about died. But with Mark Cuban, it's insane. And he's paying still, though, his bare minimum. And it's not paying down, as people were pointing out. This is not paying down anything. This is a mandatory payment at risk of penalty, at risk of imprisonment. This is not doing anything for the country. It's not going for any kind of service that you think is going to be helpful for people. They act like they're helping the downtrodden. That's not what government's for, and that's not what this is doing. And that's the big thing, Grover. The math, you could seize the wealth of every single type of Mark Cuban in the United States. And it's not going to do one thing. But from what I see, there's nothing in Democrats' proposal that talks about a reduction in any of the spending.
There isn't, because they're not interested in that. And that remains the problem. If you would like to see revenue come up, here's one way. If you grow at 3% a year for a decade instead of 2% a year, just go from 2% a year growth to 3%. We used to do 4% regularly in the United States. If you grow not at 2, but at 3% a year for one decade, that brings in $3.7 trillion more than at a lower rate of growth. The best way to bring in revenue is to have more growth. Deregulation, get those permits out now. Make things move quicker when the government, so you don't stop pipelines and other things, and take key tax rates down, like the corporate income tax, as well as the capital gains tax, that really get in the way of growth. We can grow our way around away from the debt. We had 120% of GDP in debt at the end of World War II. We didn't run big surpluses. We grew faster than the debt, and it went down to about 20 or 30%. We need to grow away from the debt, not try and feed it.
Democrats used to have that position. I mean, I remember in history learning about Kennedy talking on economic policy, and he sounds like a Republican would sound today.
John F. Kennedy's tax cut was taken from the Coolidge model of taking marginal tax rates down across the board, giving us strong growth, the roaring 20s, the 60s. And then Reagan's 80s. Gee whiz, every time we have marginal tax rate reductions, the whole decade looks good.
I love it.
And then when Hoover gets in and raises taxes, not so good. When Nixon gets in and raises taxes, not so good. And when Carter gets in and raises taxes, not so good. So we've kind of seen this play out in history, in our lifetimes, again and again and again. Lower rates to have growth, less regulation to have growth. Growth makes us grow faster than the deficit, and the same size deficit gets smaller and smaller in the rear view mirror. Growth is what we need to be doing, and raising taxes kills growth.
It does, absolutely. Talking with our friend Grover Norquist, last thing, you know, we tax day is one day, and we also, though, we have to suffer the indignity of endless taxes every single other day as well, with no relief in that. And there was a very interesting thing from John Stossel. How about the income tax is less than half of what most of us pay the government. And it's really taxation every other day aside from income tax that's also really just killing the American consumer and our savings.
Property taxes, sales taxes, excise taxes. Death taxes. If you're stupid enough to die, they can take up to half. Our friend, I did leave out on the parade of horribles, Biden has another one that he's put out there. He wants a second death tax on top of the one we already have. And that is getting rid of the step up in basis. Because right now, when he inflates the value of what you pass on to your children, you can step that up so that you don't pay taxes on all that inflation. He wants to make sure you pay taxes on all the inflation during your lifetime as if that was a value and take that away from your children. So the tax on Biden's inflation in order to make your children have less that you can pass on to them is an important part of his new plan to have more taxes.
This is why this is all the stuff that's at stake in November. I mean, oh my goodness. I have anxiety. This is great. Well, it's always great talking to you, Grover. We appreciate you joining us with this, you know, kittens and sunshine. At some point when we have a good administration and we have some good, you know, economically literate people in the House, you're going to join me and we're going to have a celebration because taxes are going to be lowered across the board. Maybe the IRS will be abolished. I don't know. I mean, maybe it could happen in my lifetime and we'll celebrate.
Brief, cheerful news. About 25 states are moving in the right direction and 10 are phasing their income taxes down to zero. So in red states, you actually have cheerful news.
Florida, Blue Texas, states. Tennessee. Yeah, it never happened in California or Illinois or New York.
Iowa,
never.
Watch Iowa, North Carolina. Arkansas, Arizona, lots of states, North Dakota bringing it down to zero. We're making real progress. Next year, New Hampshire, complete zero next year.
Wow, New Hampshire. That's one I did not have on my bingo card. That's very good news indeed. Grover Norquist with Americans for Tax Reform. You can find the website it's ATR, AmericansForTaxReform.org. Grover, always good to see you. Appreciate you, especially this time of the year.
Thank Absolutely.
You. Thanks for watching The Dana Show. Make sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, and stay tuned for more content.